So, all right. What are my thoughts on Blink-182's Neighborhoods? What's up, ladies and gents in Cyberland? Coming back to you with another album review, and this time, woo boy. Blink-182's Neighborhoods. So, I pretty much have said, what transpired after the last album. Now, we didn't have Blink-182 pretty much for about four and a half years. Tom, also I forgot to mention, Tom wouldn't perform the songs. I think he did, but then Mark kind of felt some type of way. He was like, why are you performing the songs and you left the band? You know, you didn't give a shit to try to salvage what we had, so you shouldn't be even performing them. Like, he was pissed. And at one point, Mark was just like, you know what, we're not going to perform this with plus recording plans. I said, screw this, we are going to perform these songs because we didn't break up the band. So, I'm going to perform these songs. And that's what they did. And a lot of stuff happened during this time. Jerry Finn, a great producer, one of the best producers for punk rock in the 90s, he died. He had a brain hemorrhage or he had brain cancer. The point is, it was sudden. And I wouldn't say he was the fourth member of Blink, but he really helped Blink with their sound. And with him being gone, that was one thing that struck a nerve with all of them, because they all knew him. And it was kind of a thing of maybe the Most High is trying to tell you something. And then the next thing that happened was Travis Barker nearly died in a plane crash. He was on a plane with DJ AM and a couple other people, and only him and DJ AM survived. Everybody else died. Plane came down, and it wasn't a huge plane, but it was a smaller plane, and everybody else didn't make it. Travis was pretty much, I guess, almost all of his clothes were torn. He was burned to a crisp. He was burnt up pretty bad. And DJM wasn't too well either. And he was almost out of here. Like, and that really affected. That really affected Travis for a long time. I don't know if I think he's kind of gotten therapy. I think he's kind of been able to be better about it. But that really screwed with him for a long time. I don't really like flying either, so I totally see how to do that. And then not too long after that, DJ AM died of a drug overdose. So at one point, Travis was literally the only survivor of that plane crash in the scheme of things. And Tom knew DJ AM, and I think Mark did too. So all these things are happening, one after another. And I think Tom realized that Mark was with Travis like the majority of when all these things happened. But Tom, I think he was starting to realize, what was the point of me doing what I did? I mean, Mark did his shit too. But I think Tom was realizing, what was the point of what I did? What did me doing what I did do it? What did it do? We lost Jerry. We nearly lost Travis. I haven't spoken to Mark in years, and this is like my best friend. And for what? So, at some point, Tom sent Travis two pictures. It was like a thing of, do you remember who we were? Do you remember, and do you see who we are now? And it was like, before this was us, and now it's us with kids kind of thing, or something like that. And him and Mark, and they all reconciled. And there was no talk about making any music. That's what they said. And then eventually they felt like they could. Of course, Angel and Airwoods, I think, already had three albums or two albums. I only have the first one. I didn't really care for the rest of the material moving forward. It wasn't my thing. I don't want to hear guitars, and I'm hearing all this echoing and stuff. And plus 44, I think the record label wasn't going to finance them for another album for whatever reason. And I guess Mark and Travis were kind of doing other things at the moment. I don't know. But I thought Plus 44 was a pretty good album, too. It was very good. It was like the direction Blink could have went, too. Anyway, so the band gets back together, and at some point, there's not really... They announced to the public at a Grammy Show Award and award show. And it was kind of like... It's nice that you announced it, but it could have been done somewhere else, because at this point, the Grammys are already starting to become a joke, if not already, or the award shows. It's kind of like people have been calling a circle jerk for so long anyway. And the band comes out, and they start recording. But the recording was a little different. It was distributed. So we end up getting Up All Night, and at first, when it came out, it showed up on YouTube, it kept getting deleted, and somehow people kept putting it back out there for people to listen to, and it was cool. It was nice. It was nice to hear them again. It felt darker, but Tom's voice felt a lot different. I gotta get some water in my face. Ooh. Gotta have some water. But Tom's voice kind of felt like Angels and Airwaves as opposed to what he sounded with before Blink broke up. So it was kind of weird, but it was cool. It was nice to just hear them together again, and I liked the song. Some people didn't. Some people felt like, what is this? I was just like, look, you know what? Take it for what it is. If you want to be stuck in 03, fine. If not, listen to the music and shut up, because at this point, things are not going to be like how it was at 03. There's too much shit that happened. They're trying to move forward, be in a band. Let them move forward. If you want to be on board, cool. If not, then get off. You know, get off the train. So then, I think it was like a month or two later, Hearts All Gone came out. And I remember when I first heard it, I just felt like, is this about Tom? It just gave that vibe, but probably wasn't. But it really did give that vibe. But the drumming for Travis was... It felt like when they worked on that track, like Travis had been wanting to get out all that aggression with Blink or something. Because, man, he's a... If you see people play that song, like cover it, or see him play it, that song is just nuts. Like on the drumming part, just this. It's crazy. So, heard that, and then After Midnight also came out as a single, and it was good. It was. A lot of people felt that was like the Blink song of. That was like Blink, like an updated version of Blink. That felt like the closest to what Blink was and what they are now. I guess to me it was just a Blink song, and I liked it. And then the other song I had heard, but it was live, was Ghost on the Dance Floor. I loved how Travis was playing the beginning of the song. I thought that was really, really cool. But that song was about DJ AM. Go figure. So the album drops, and come to find out there's two versions of the album. There's one with 10 tracks, and there's one with actually 14 tracks, which I thought was stupid. I felt like there shouldn't have been a deluxe edition. It just should have been one album. I don't understand who the hell said, let's have... a 10-track album and a 14-track album, you're like, this is fucking stupid. Like, it wasn't that much. Technically, it was 13 tracks as opposed to 10. Because one of the tracks is Hearts All Gone intro, like instrumental. Which really should have just been top. I technically combined those two songs together because it's really just one song. And this is right there. And it was good. I like the album. I give it a 4.5 out of 5 yes sirs. There wasn't a song I didn't like. However, I kind of felt like there wasn't too many chances being taken. And I really think it was like what Mark said, that they were trying to just get used to playing with each other again and not being so nitpicky, because they didn't want to step on each other's toes. And I get it. I really do. And it was good. Some people didn't like it. Some people didn't like Neighborhoods, and they felt like that was it. You know, it just wasn't very good. But then also, you look at what was coming out at the time, and most bands weren't really doing much. I mean, Green Day was doing their thing. But outside of that, there was another couple of bands coming up, but a lot of bands had already had their time to shine, and they're really... I'm sorry to take, you know, whoever's watching this, I'm not trying to offend, but most of the fucking bands that were coming out were not very good. I'm not saying because I'm older, but they just didn't have anything that made them unique. They were trying to sound too much like a hip-hop group or like pop music. There was like, let's throw out the guitars and bring in a keyboard. And I'm just like, what the fuck is this? Or they would have a guitar, but you couldn't hear the damn thing. Like, do you got the... Is the amp on? Because I don't hear shit. You know? It was just... You had so many bands at that time to where it was like... Outside of Green Day and Blink, it was just kind of like... You know? And then Sum 41 to an extent. But it was just like... Do we have anybody else? Because I'm not hearing... You know, and then Korn, but Korn, and I get to them, they had their issues, literally, and they weren't the same at the time. And who else do we have? You know, Slipknot, but Slipknot wasn't coming out with albums every year. They normally release an album every 4 to 5 years, so who else we got? You know, it was just Metallica, they hadn't released anything since 08. I think it was Death Magnetic, so it was just like, who we got? Offspring? No. They already, you know, they were taking a long time to release something. So it just, that era just kind of, that time frame, I just felt like the bands that were coming out, they just weren't very good. I just remember, I don't even remember buying very many band albums that year. I don't even think I bought a lot of music that year. Probably bought a handful of full of albums, because a lot of it was mostly the old school, the bands I listened to, but mostly all the new stuff was just fucking terrible. It was just like, what is this shit? It's just like, dude, just be a fucking pop group. Like, literally, just be a pop group or be a hip-hop pop group, because at this point, you guys are not playing anything that's even at all some type of rock and roll, and that's fine, but... Don't try to fucking say you're a rock band or start telling people you're not a rock band, because you guys ain't playing anything that resembles rock and roll at all. I don't hear no fucking guitars. I don't hear no bass. I hear drums, and that's it. And drums can be used in any type of music. It was just like, ugh. So that's my little rant. But yeah, it was just that, you know, it was just a weird time with music, I think, for me in general with that. But anyway... My top 5 tracks are Natives, Snake Charmer, Kaleidoscope, Hearts All Gone. Of course, Hearts All Gone is amazing. And I always jump between MH 418 2011 or... we'll just do Up All Night. Thing though. To this day, before I go... MH 18, 2011. I feel that that song, I don't know why, but it just gave me this American Pie feel, you know? Like, it just felt like American Pie, like it should have been on American Reunion. I don't know why. I just, you know, you say American Pie out of Mud and American Pie 2 had Every Time I Look For You. But this song just gave me American Pie vibes. I don't know what it was. I just felt like it should have been on that movie. It should have been in that movie. It just gave this American Pie feel. I don't know. I can't explain. I just feel it, you know? So with that being said, I would just, if you're a fan of Blank, listen to it. If you're not a fan, then whatever. It's disjointed, but I like it. But it's also the last time that, outside of the EP, which I'm not reviewing that, but it's the last time Tom recorded with Mark and Travis album-wise. He hasn't done it since. We're now in 2021. This was, I think, when was this? 2011. Yeah. So actually, yeah, 2011, like, the bands were just like, yeah, whatever. So, let's cue the music. I'm like a cat in a cage, locked up and battered and bruised. I am the prod of the sun, a shameful prodigy too. I am the love of your life, battering, ramming, confused. I turn each day into night, I stand there waiting for you. There is desire to fight, but I am nothing to prove. With the crowd and some lights, I start to feel things move. Do you have something to hide? Cause I think that we all do. I am a child inside, back up and give me some room. I'm just a bastard child, don't let it go to your head. I'm just a waste of your time, maybe I'm better off dead. You turn us loose in the night, I'm fucking Jekyll and Hyde. We'll have the time of our lives, although we're dying inside. So let me go.